We all know 2020 being a COVID year, education to all the students affected from primary schools to colleges. 8 to 9 months passed by without proper teaching. When it comes to MBBS, medical students got affected by this lapse in academics more than anyone. All the batches of MBBS are affected equally, but I see final MBBS students are more affected than others. But why? Final year is the time where most of the medical students learn clinically compared to other years. And all the major subjects will be taught from medicine to pediatrics. They learn and get insight of things in this final year itself. As all that time is lost now, they are affected, but somehow all the colleges restarted and many universities have given them the final exam schedules. I see many universities are conducting final exams in the month of March and April. So I thought, let's give them a plan to study and help them get done with this final year with good marks. So here in this video, I will give you a complete guide to how to study, what books to study, how to plan your schedules and many more. And this will be helpful for all the final year students from all the states. So watch till the end. But before we get into the video, do subscribe to my channel and also click bell icon for notifications. And are you ready to get started with the plan? Hey guys, if you're new here, this is Dr. JT, General Medicine Resident, and welcome to my channel, Dr. JTM. So as exam dates were announced for final MBBS students, what to do now? First, gather the courage to start your preparation. Don't think about post-exam consequences. Whether you pass or fail doesn't matter. Firstly, you need a beginning to your preparation. Everyone will have equal chance of clearing the final prof exams. How to start the preparation? As we know that question paper contains 10 marks, 4 marks and 2 marks, start with composite reading. So what's that? Many students think that they first complete all the 10 marks, then they move on to all 4 marks, then they move on to all 2 marks. That is actually a bad plan. When you start 10 marks and wanted to complete them all at once, you will get saturated after 2 to 3 questions. And the next 2 days, you will lose interest. So when you select a chapter, look what are the essays in the chapter, 4 marks in the chapter and 2 marks in the chapter. Then make sets like 1 10 marks and 2 4 marks, or 3 4 marks and 4 2 marks, or 1 10 marks and 5 2 marks. This will help in quick completing of the syllabus and slowly boost up your preparation and increase your pace. Way to start preparation. Lots of people have this confusion. Which subject should I start? Which chapter should I start? So here is a solution for you guys. Start a subject that you have personal interest in. Like few people are more into surgery because they find it fascinating or they want to become surgeons in the future. And few find medicine is full of concepts, so you people start studying medicine. Fact is that it's tough to make a start, but once you do, you will be in a flow. What books to study? Your favorite part, isn't it? Sir, shall we start studying standard books like Harrison, Bailey and Love, or read only exam-oriented books? No worries. I will mention the required book names that will be more than enough for exams. And I suggest don't start studying standard books now because now is not time for them. So in order of preference, for medicine, Davidson, Ramdas Naik and George Matthews are the suggested books. First preference is Davidson, the second is Ramdas Naik will be good enough. For surgery, SRB Manual of Surgery or Manipal Book of Surgery will be more than enough for exams. For obstetrics, Datta is very good book for exams, but some feel it tough, so second option is Mudaliar. It makes topics suitable to write in the exams. For gynecology, short textbook of gynecology is prime option. If not, other book you can go for is Datta's Gynecology. For orthopedics, one and only Maheshwari book of orthopedics, neat and crisp enough for scoring good in the exam. For pediatrics, OP guy is the best in the business, but you ask me the second option, then go for Mukesh Agrawal. How to start my next 30 days of preparation? 3 sets of 10 days of rotational plan. What is that rotational plan? First set will have 10 days and will be divided likewise. 2 days for medicine, 1 day for pediatrics, 2 days for surgery, 1 day for orthopedics, 2 days for obstetrics, 1 day for pediatrics and 1 day for gynecology. Then on rotation of next set of 10 days, we will start with gynecology first. 1 day of gynecology, 2 days for surgery, 1 day for orthopedics, 2 days for medicine, 1 day for pediatrics, 2 days of obstetrics, 1 day for orthopedics. Then third set of 10 days into this rotational plan. 2 days of surgery, 1 day for orthopedics, 2 days of medicine, 1 day of pediatrics, 2 days of gynecology, 1 day of obstetrics, 1 day for medicine. So that's how we make a plan to study for next 30 days. In the stipulated time, try to cover all the important topics that would cover 60 to 70% of the subjects. After 30 days, if you have time to your exam date, start the revision of the subjects. If you start revision, study at least 2 subjects in a day. How to study each subject? What is the approach? First thing that comes into our mind when we think of medicine is, it is vast, it is huge, it is very big. So let's tune our brain with small topics of medicine so that we get interest onto the big topics. So what are the small topics that are easy and also important to study? Poisoning, psychiatry, dermatology, geriatrics, clinical biochemistry and metabolic diseases. You can start with this. They take less time to study and also have less questions to study. What are the systems that you should read first? In order of preference, CVS, respiratory system, GIT, renal, hematology and CNS. Target these primarily and then go for others. I have made a list of important questions for general medicine and you can download that PDF from the link in the description. Next subject, surgery. Another biggie. But what is the approach towards this surgery? First, finding grip in the first paper topics is very important to gain confidence in this surgery. So what are those topics that you need to cover first? Wound healing, infectious diseases, electrolyte and nutrition, shock, hemorrhage, burns and arterial diseases. And chapters to be covered first when it comes to systemic. Order of preference is breast, thyroid, stomach, esophagus, pancreas, liver, urology, salivary glands. Try completing them first, then go for others. Important questions for surgery, find the link in the description. Next subject, obstetrics. Most of the times, they give questions from majority of the stock chapters. So target them first and complete it. What are they in order of preference? Hypertensive disorders in pregnancy, twins, medical emergencies in pregnancy, antepartum hemorrhage, abortion, normal labor, complicated labor, complications in third stage of labor, operative obstetrics. These will get you some good amount of weightage of marks. So complete these first. Moving on to gynecology, trick of this subject is, if we study all the important essays, most of the 4 marks will also be covered. So what are those important essay topics that we should cover first? Order of priority, AUB, amenorrhea, fibroids, endometriosis, adenomyosis, infertility, ectopic gestation, pelvic inflammatory disease, carcinoma ovary, carcinoma cervix, and carcinoma uterus. These should be your primary targeted topics, and you can find the list of important questions to these obstetrics and gynecology in the link in the description. Next subject, pediatrics. Most underrated subject in the MBBS by every final year student. Most of you think if you read medicine, peds will be easy. No, the story is different. Don't neglect thinking like that. What is the approach to pediatrics? Cover the first 10 chapters from growth and development to immunization. You need to be thorough with all the questions from these chapters. Systemic is a bit troublemaker, but primary topics to be covered in order of preference is CVS, hematology, respiratory, GIT, genetic disorders, and CNS. Preparing these topics will cover majority of the exam portion, and you will be able to answer most of these questions. Important questions list is placed in the description below for the pediatrics. Last subject, orthopedics. Most of the essays are predictable from orthopedics, and major topics to be covered in order of priority is hip injuries, femur injuries, infections of bones and joints, TB of bones, bone tumors, arthritis and degenerative disorders, metabolic bone disorders and CTEV. Study all these first and move on to others. Link to all the important questions list is in the description. Do not miss them. And we have a Telegram group for all the UG MBBS students where we have placed handwritten notes of all the important questions from all the subjects. Do join our Telegram channel and access to that notes for free. We made your preparation easy. How to plan each day? The race in time strategy. At the beginning, you may find difficult to study continuously for hours. Begin studying for 45 minutes, then take a break of 5 minutes. Put a timer of 5 minutes as the break shouldn't prolong from 5 minutes to 5 hours. So first 2 days, take a break for every 45 minutes of studying. Then raise the time duration of studying for 1 hour and break of 5 minutes. Breaks are important as you're loading your brain after 8 long months. You will get saturated very easily. So during the break, listen to a song or have a coffee or a candy. Things to be avoided during this 30 days of preparation. First, stop procrastinating and start working. You will make progress on a daily basis and don't always message or call your friends asking how much they are studying or what are they studying or at least they are studying or not. Frankly speaking, even your best friends will tell lies in this aspect. Second, decrease your phone usage. The toughest task, right? But for 30 days only. Mostly decrease the usage of the time killer social media apps and remove the apps that you are spending most of your time on. Lastly, avoid group discussions or group studying. Clarifying doubts is okay, but group discussion leads to nothing but talking on useless things and it's a waste of time. Frequently asked questions by all the final year MBBS students. Will I pass if I start my preparation now? Straight answer. Yes, you will pass. You have time, make a start and you will pass. Will the important questions be enough or should I start studying entire textbook? First, complete all the important ones. If you have enough time, then go for other topics also. Should I make notes for the questions that I study? Yes, making notes is always a good habit. Make notes of some very important points during your studying period so that will be useful during your revision time. Next question. How to remember the subject that I study? All the subjects are very volatile in the final year, so memorizing is the key. This is achieved by pictorial representation. Take a paper, draw a flowchart of symptoms or the treatment that you study, and the notes that you are making during your preparation will also help you remember what you study. Is it good if we see marrow and prep letter videos of all the final year subjects and prepare? No, now is not the time to prepare that way. Next question. Is it okay to use marrow and prep letter materials during our preparation? Yes, it's very good to use those materials. Finally, isn't there a question that is running in your mind that why do I have to struggle this much or work hard so much in this final year? I will tell you why you have to. It's not just for the degree. It's for the pride of your parents, for holding on high with your self-respect. It is the year, if you get through, the perception of the society towards you will change. All this is for one final step to be called as doctor officially. Good luck, just get it on with your preparation. That is everything I had for you guys, and how to write an answer in the exam and how to present it well on the paper to get good marks, I will make another video. Hope you all love this video, hoping this planning and strategy will help you all. And don't forget to like this video and share this with your friends and also subscribe to my channel, Dr. JTM. I will come back with another great video. Till then, bye, see you again.